you over to a tree stump. As you approach, he places two items side by side on the stump.
One will make your enemies your friends. The other is a poison. Which shall you drink? Quickly, quickly, choose!
There's a bomb and a bottle marked poison. Well, obviously we'll just take the bomb, because you can't drink a bomb. I'll pick the bomb. Thanks, man. What a guy. I'm gonna keep what I got on for now. The goblin watches expectantly until you feign drinking the bomb. Satisfied with the proceedings, the old goblin gives you a little wave and climbs up a nearby tree. A band of skeletons emerges from the thick. Ready or what? I might use my bomb on these guys. This game is out now, yeah, it just came out today. Come here, you. Look at that gathering. Oh, shit. That went over great. You continue your journey, wondering how you'll next encounter Oswin's goblin uncle.
God damn it, Oswin.
You awaken one morning to find Oswin completely vanished. Of course. Of course. Thanks, Oswin. Oswin's time is limited. The old maiden again. Hey, I'm gonna need a... You know what? I'll take the gold.
No amount of gold will satisfy a mortal, but if that is what you wish...
Her ancient voice falters on the words, as if long unused. Thank you, I needed some money for the fair.
In case you're wondering whether I take it personally, these purges of the corrupt, indeed I do. How could I not?
Hey, Crow, what do you think of the full game now that it's out? Well, I've had the full game. It's the same experience that I've been having. I think it's just a good game. It's a good time. Absolutely worth it. The town crier announces the Empire seeks mercenaries to join the battle against corruption. You seek out the watchtower where recruitment is taking place. You arrive in town to hear Sir Malafowl's plan to wipe out the Pauper's district. The outbreak there began there, and we cannot risk sparing anyone of their lives, he says. Why is he wearing MLG glasses, Lel? Who really knows? Sir Malafowl the Green leads the mercenaries to the Pauper District, where the poor and sick have been walled off from the rest of the city. As you hear the wailing of the corrupted, Sir Malafowl gives his command to charge. Well, we'll get hot fucking money for this, so hell yeah, dude. You find yourself surrounded by corrupted. You draw your weapon and set your feet. I'll do it. I'm sorry, Kay. I'm killing innocent people. It's just what I do these days. One could say I've gone renegade. Maybe, right? Like, if this was a choice on a Mass Effect game, it'd be red. $7. That ain't bad.
Well done.
I got the medal token.
Sir Malafowl commends you for your bravery and offers you a reward. 20 frickin' gold. And 10 gold. Alright, that was hecka worth. Give me, I don't need it. I'm good. find Osmond surrounded by bandits, swinging his pitchfork wildly and threatening to use their tailbones to till the farm. Alright. His elbow, you were killing his people. I don't know what you're talking about. I would never do something like that, though. It's all good. If I just stay over here, maybe they won't go over by Osmond. Maybe. That's the dream, anyway. I think it might actually be working. Leave him alone. He's just a potato man. You have iframes when you do that. It's pretty good. Let me tell you about the iframes. They stand for invincibility frames. That means you can't get hit. It's pretty great. It's a feral shy guy for 19 months. Yo, Cry, I don't remember when I started watching, nor do I have a story about how you inspire me for anything great. I just think you and the rest of the LNC are okay dudes who can make any game entertaining, well, except WoW and Secret Hitler. Excuse me? Alright. I get WoW. That's fine. But Secret Hitler is amazing. That is always a good time. How dare you, sir? I am offended. Also, Stanky and Sushi. He searched the bias for anything of use. Score an exact target value in a dice gambit to draw two equipment cards and discard this card. Not bad. Five food, I'll need that. Keep a close eye on the potato farmer, sure you don't think he's going to kidnap the cat, dude. He'll be fine. It's fine. We're good. Gorsh. Okay, you know what? Let's just rest here. Food for sale. Well, okay. Osmond, go ahead and eat food. He's gotta heal up. I can't risk him dying. Once he dies, it's all over, man. No, thank you at that point. Alright. He'll heal as soon as we move the card now, and we'll be fully healed. It'll be great. Okay, trade. Equipment. Humble hammer. I have 12 fame already, though. I don't think that's gonna be worth it. Food will be overpriced here. I don't really need it right now, I have 14. I think it's okay. I think we could just go with what we're doing. Probably. Yeah, if I sold this warrior's axe, I could get the humble hammer, but I'd have literally nothing left. Should risk him, by the way. Anyone who says Secret Hitler's a bad game, come at me, bro. I agree. Your name is literally spawned because of that game. Alright, yeah. I think we're good. Winding trail. Suddenly, a tree falls across your path, blocking the way ahead. Weapons bristle from the trees around you, their wielders' faces obscured by the undergrowth. Give us all of your gold or die.
Wow. I never asked for this.
Hold on a second. I never asked for this. Also, Kirk Poon's World. PogChamp, I'll buy this game as soon as I'm home. Hell yeah, dude. Absolutely do it. You prepare for combat. Goddamn ass conditions. Kill your friends. No, Oswin, you dummy! Get out of there! You're in the middle of them! Don't you know you're... No, 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 Oswin. Alright, Ozma. Please. I know you think you're helping, but goddamn you're not. I just got you fully healed, man. Oh, and now I'm dying. Cries in trouble. Save him. No, Oswin. I'm fine. It's okay. You don't got him. With the cowards subdued, the thugs plead for their lives. Please, for pity's sake, we only want food to feed our families. Well, that's a shame that you would do that. Give me your stuff. Reluctantly, the bandits hand over their spoils. I got the humble hammer.
A violent tool for the lower classes.
I already got the token on my other one. I have a feeling this is going to be weaker because of all the fame that I have. But I'll equip it anyway. You didn't... You wake one night to the sound of Oswin's muffled screams. Yet more skeletons are attempting to kidnap Oswin. Thanks. Oh, shit. I'm not sure where this one is, actually. Fuck. Why does this happen? I really gotta sneeze in the head. Here it is. Okay, I thought it was gonna be two. It was just one. It's okay. Coast is clear. We're safe. We're fine. I'm gonna go for this one. I'm gonna do it. Cause I believe in you, chat. Chat, you didn't fuck up! Look at you, chat! Holy shit! Hold on a second, there's a lot of bad dudes here. There we go. Seven of skulls and a... Oh god, dude. Oh, this is gonna be a lot of dudes. I knew you guys could pull through. The whole time, I believed. Show me my helmet. Speak softly and carry a huge piece of iron on the end of a stick. Well, I guess it'll have to do. No, Oswin. Leave them alone, Oswin. Even if it's not as good as the other one, because I don't think it isn't. It's more so I'm not sure because of its effect on F fame. Sorry. Oswin, don't get stabbed. Stop it. Thank you. Alright, I definitely gotta heal him after this. When did Crab become dad? He's more like a cool cousin you can actually talk to at family events. I know that exact kind of family member. You rummage through the bones for anything of use. Okay, that's not a bad card to get. Well. Probably just get this one. Yeah. Yes, okay, I need food. Food is always good. Skeletons dispatched, you fall back into sleep. Nice. Alright, so. Do I need to do anything here? I think I'm good. No, his health is at 63. Let's just move forward. See what happens.
Can you claim this token?
Oh, shit. Oh, God. Oh, man. Do it. Shadowy beasts descend from the trees and tear your flesh. Fearing for your life, you flee the forest.
Shit! I don't know how to get that thing. Fuck.
Enter the inn. Osmond disappears briefly and returns with a potato pastry. You watch him take a bite with gusto.
Oi!
A growl echoes from across the inn. A hulking northerner grabs your companion by the arm.
That was my pastry, little man.
The potato farmer looks up at his furious assailant, then down to the crisp, warm pastry. To your exasperation, he appears to be considering eating it anyway. I'll calm him down. Gonna go for the gold. Got it. You cobble together a speech linking the liberty of the pastry with the freedom of those in the Empire, willing to stand up and take it. The northerners are moved to tears. Someone grabs your face in his enormous gnarled hands and blesses you with a gentle headbutt. The dude's hardcore as fuck. I got a text message from someone asking what I want for dinner. Huh. I told them spaghetti. Because I'm Italian. After losing 4 precision gambits with a failure or huge failure, draw 5 equipment cards.
Wow! 5.
You rest a while before continuing your journey. That's pretty intense. What? Why did I get hurt? What happened? Shit. Buy food. We're hungry. Get food. Nice. We're really poor now and we can't afford all this cool shit. Would have been nice. But we can't. Honestly, I might just buy another bit of food here. Now we're poor again, but that's okay. It happens. Everything I want to sell. I'll be fine with that again. It's fine. My people want to kill Crying, alright? And he gets kidnapped again. You wake one night to the sound of Osmond's muffled screams. You sigh as another platoon of skeletons. Oh, wait, I got hurt because you guys voted for it. Oh, so you guys are rude. Thanks, guys. You sigh as another platoon of skeletons drag Osmond away into the forest. He seems somewhat resigned to it now, not struggling so much. Fuck. I think it's 1. That's my guess. I'm gonna blow my nose really quick. I know it sounds gross and all, but I gotta do it. I just gotta do it, right? I'm fucking sorry. Either. You poop too! Don't lie to people! Stop lying to them! Also, wash your hands. And wash your hands with soap!
Ho, 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 you make a poor apprentice. Cultivate focus.
Excuse me, I'm cultivating hygiene. Get off my dick, old man.
Let's see, everybody's saying 2, huh? I thought it was 1. So you know what? You know what? I'm gonna pick 1. Because I don't believe you guys. Fuck me. Jackass.
Alright, you know what? I'm sorry. You know what? I'm here on my knees, apologizing to you. That's my fault. That's on me. You run into Oswin's goblin uncle. He beckons you over to a tree stump. The goblin reaches out with a wrinkled hand.
An artifact, if you will.
I don't think I have any, actually. Oh, these. Yeah, do you take this one? This one's kind of not my favorite. He bashes the artifact a few times with his staff, then shakes it vigorously by his ears, as if listening for anything amiss. The artifact makes a whirring, rattling sound as he does it. Then, without warning, the old goblin flings the artifact back at you, smacking it into your shoulder. Oh, it recharges it. Fuck. Should have given him the other one. Ah, well.
Goodbye, dear one.
Osmond's goblin uncle bows deeply, seats himself on the nearest tree stump, and proceeds to pointedly ignore you. That's fair. You find Oswin being dragged along a lonely forest path by shuffling skeletons. I really definitely should have not have given him that one, but that's okay.
Ow!
Good enough for me. I don't have it anymore, but damn was it worth it. I did not want Oswin to get killed there. You rummage through the bones of anything of use. Four enemies. Combat boosts life to 75 when life drops below 25. 10 gold. You wonder how it's possible that someone would want to kill Oswin this much, even if it's out of love. Keep a close eye on the potato farmer, surely you think he won't get kidnapped again. Yeah, wishful thinking, Doug. Alright, so this is no more charges. Gotcha. This one's hurting. Should I heal him now? Let's just see what this is.
The final reunion.
Oh,
how
shit.
Fitting and how sweet.
Yo, hold up. Hold up. Not right now. Jesus. Fuck. Oswin, you're gonna need some health for this, I think, buddy. Go ahead and heal up first. Yeah. There you go, you good? Alright. We'll heal ourselves now. Okay, and trade. Jesus, it's expensive here. Alright, yeah, we're good. We might finish this fucking quest. I gotta go up and down though. Oh, this thing. A traveling cartographer in the process of making the first full map of the Empire wishes to pay you gold for the information on areas you have seen in your recent travels. I need not know every stream or stone that lies from here to the capital. I'm sure whatever knowledge you can provoke or provide will be of some worth. I'll take 10 gold. The cartographer listens intently as you relate what you can remember of the neighboring areas. He spent several hours in his company until he's satisfied that you have nothing else useful to add. No token this time.
Fuck! I just had to go back in the- Oh, man.
I swear to God, something terrible happens here. He says another two skeletons drag him away into the forest!
Come on.
I think it's one, but it's probably not. Actually, it might be two. I don't know. Fuck, man. Fuck. This is. Like, I just gotta get through this one, and then I should be okay, right? Like, I can take whatever the boss is. Probably. Maybe. I don't know. Shit. I always say one.
Look how close these two are! problem. This is a huge issue I'm having right now. Don't say what you think it is, then chat starts voting for it. Oh. But then you'll never know if I was right. There's a lose-lose situation. I think you carry your own regardless, by the way. Happy anniversary, man. Alright. I'm gonna go for two. Because that's the most votes. It was two! Those are two hordes of skeletons. Fuck. Well, okay. Fuck. Come on, Oswin. For the love of God, don't die here. You know what? Kill each other. Are you backstabbing them? Oh, that you. Oh, God. Oswin, stop it. Just stop it, Oswin. There we go. Alright, he took a few hits, but we still have the food to heal him. We also get spoils of war from these. We can heal Oswin with food, yeah. You're not much of the bones for anything of use. Equipment, please be good. Exquisite blade, I can
truly
sell
this. A thing of beauty and immaculate craftsmanship. Nice. But is it merely for show?
Alright, that's all looking pretty good. I'd actually be very content with that. Let's just heal Oswin real quick. Takes one food for 5 health, by the way. Fully healed there. We're gonna sell the exquisite blade. So the warrior's axe. Actually, I don't know if I'm gonna need that kind of stuff. So I might keep those that I'm not using, of course. And you sell billy clubs. The 24 fame. I think it'd be smarter to keep the hammer that I got. Okay, I think we're good.
True love transcends life. True revenge also.
The submission my game is still set to getting over it. That's because usually mods do that, and there's like no mods today. I think all the mods are just having their own days. Got it. I also don't normally stream this early, too. So there's that. Okay. With a shout of relief, Oswin announces that Nightshade Copse is just over the hill. Okay. The village looks abandoned. The sky darkens. In the town square stands a beautiful woman, her skin gray and mottled. You feel a sudden chill in the air. The woman's voice grates and hisses as if long in use.
Dearest Oswin, you have come for me.
Entranced, the potato farmer takes a step. You grab his shoulder, breaking the spell. The woman squints in your direction.
Oswin, who is this?
Your companion looks at you, still in a daze. You notice that, somehow, he's clutching a potato. Oswin grips the potato in both hands. He looks back at his lover in defiance.
This is my friend.
A heartbroken screech wrenches from the woman, and she doubles over in pain. Horrified, you watch as her face twists and hollows, and your limbs lengthen, until before you stands a shade, swirling with fury. Fuck my goddamn oak. I really wish I still had the killing all skeletons card. Fuck. The ghostly figure lifts her arm.